you tell me a little bit about the project that you're currently working on and how it deals with propulsion systems?
I work with a fish that is from the Amazon River. It's called the knife fish. And something that is really interesting about that fish is that their body is mostly straight, but they undulate like a long ribbon fin. And they can undulate that fin and they can propel in forward motion, but they can actually reverse the motion of that fin and they can move backwards. Or they can have different type of wave along that fin and they can move even upward or to the sides.
So what are some of, specifically, some of the components that went into creating this, mimicking this knife fish?
We have 16 different motors. Each of these motors has some drivers so we can control them. We have also a microprocessor to control the motors. And also we have different type of sensoring. But right now the focus or the main components are for controlling the motion of the fin and also get a feedback of the motion of the vehicle itself.
And so what sort of applications do you foresee for this type of machine that you're creating?
I mean, there could be many applications. Inspection of underwater structure for other type of ships, if we have to do any type of inspections. Also, there are applications, of course, in defense and surveillance.
You recently got a grant from the Navy. Do you know what they're going to be using this technology for?
The grant itself that we got is for instrumentation. It's for doing volumetric flow measurements.
And what's the sort of technology that allows this 3D volumetric measurement to be made?
So the main part of this equipment basically is like a powerful laser that illuminates a volume. And also we have, in this case, we have four cameras synchronized with the laser to capture a different perspective, that volume. And with the image of that, four different cameras, we can recreate the 3D flow.
And how do you expect this volumetric testing will sort of impact, what you find about how fish move or how your specific prototype works?
This will allow us to understand the flow in a more realistic type of way. And also it's going to improve our flow measurements when we have extreme maneuvers.
And in what types of underwater vehicles do you see foresee this technology being useful?
That type of system will be again for complex environments that could go into hopefully small spaces and maybe that we can have many of them and then they can work as a collaborative system, basically.
Okay, Dr. Curet, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, my pleasure.